Amen.
Go where you need God's back.
That's right, that's right.
I ain't got to go to that. And you shall receive. All right. Will draw nigh unto us, oh God. And if we lift you up, oh God, today, that
All men will be drawn to you today, O God. So, Lord, today we come before you, O God, humbly, O God, as we know how, Lord God. Comely, Lord God, boldly before the throne of grace, O God, that we might obtain help and mercy in the time of our need today, O God. And, Lord, we glorify you. We honor you. We worship you in this place, O God. We lift you up, O God, today. We invite you in this place, O God. We invite you in this house, O God, to move, shake, rattle, and roll our cages today, O God. Move, O God, on our behalf, O God. Shake our spiritual cage today, O God. Shake our hearts today, O God. Shake our minds today, O God. Wake us up, O God. Wake us up, O God, those who sleep, O God. Wake them up, O God. Knowing the time, O God, is at hand, O God. Lord, I pray, Lord God, that we be doing your work when you come, O God. Lord, let us not be slowful, O God, when you come back, O God. Let us be on the watch, O God, when you come back, O God. Lord, I pray, Lord God, that you come quickly, O God. Yes, we know, Lord. O God, that you're coming soon today,
yes,
O God.
Lord, Jesus.
Lord, we pray, Lord God, people will be ready for you, O God.
Yes, Lord,
that
Jesus.
We be spotless and blemish without blemish or wrinkle, O God.
Yes, Lord,
Lord,
Jesus.
Let us be the bride, O God, that you called us to be in these last evil
Jesus.
Days, O God. Lord, we cast all of our cares upon you, O God.
Yes, Lord,
for you
Jesus.
Care for us today, O God. Lord, whenever we come in this place, O God, burden,
yes,
shaking,
Lord.
O God, I pray, Lord God, that you just
yes,
remove
Lord,
every
Jesus.
Hindrance, O God.
Lord,
everything that is not like you,
yes,
O God,
Lord,
let
Jesus.
Us lay it aside, O God,
yes,
every
Lord.
Sin and the weight that so easily beset us, O
yes,
God.
Lord,
let
Jesus.
Us lay it down at the altar,
right
O God.
Now, Lord,
let
Jesus.
Us get right with you today,
right
O God.
Now, Lord,
Lord, we thank you, O God.
Right
we
now,
thank
Lord.
You for mercy and grace,
right
O God,
now,
today.
Jesus.
Lord, have mercy on your
have
people,
mercy,
O God,
Lord,
where
Jesus.
Mercy can be found today,
have
O God.
Mercy, Lord,
Lord, bless
Jesus.
Your mercy.
Yes,
bless your
Lord,
people
Jesus.
Today, O God. Bless your leaders, O God.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, touch our bishop and our lady,
yes,
O God.
Jesus.
Strengthen them,
right
O God.
Jesus.
Touch them, O God.
The
from the crown
right
of their head
Jesus.
To the sole of their feet,
yes,
O God.
Lord,
everything,
Jesus.
O God.
Right now,
Lord, we rebuke
Jesus.
It in the name of Jesus.
Yes, Lord,
every
Jesus.
Sickness is not unto death.
Yes, Lord,
we speak
Jesus.
Healing, O God.
Right
in
now,
the name
Lord,
of still Jesus,
Jesus,
O God. We know you to be a healer, O God.
Yes,
if
Lord,
you heal
Jesus.
Back then, O God,
yes,
you're the same
Lord,
yesterday, today, and forever,
right
O God.
Jesus.
We believe you to be
yes,
an on time,
Lord,
God. We believe
right
you to
now,
be
Lord,
a healer
Jesus.
And a deliverer and
right
our Savior today, O God.
Lord,
right bless,
Lord,
O God.
Jesus.
Bless those that are on the way, O God.
Right
oh,
Lord,
let us not leave here the same way we came in, O God. Let us get more of you, O God.
Right
let us know you more, O God. And Lord, we praise you, we honor you, we glorify you.
Lord,
we need you right now, O God. Lord, move in a mighty way, O God. Sweep this house, O God. Sweep this sanctuary, O God. Lord, come in, O God, with the fire, O God. Come in like a flood, O God. Let us raise the standard, O God. We will obey. We will be the people, O God, that you will raise up in these last and evil days, O God. You said you would raise up a generation that will obey.
Thank
you, Lord, God. A part of that, oh God.
Yes,
help
Lord,
us
Jesus.
Today, oh God. In
thank
the name
Lord,
of Jesus, we praise you, we honor
thank
you,
Lord,
and we glorify
Jesus.
You. In Jesus' mighty name, we praise
Jesus.
You. Amen and amen and amen.
Amen.
Come on, let's give the Lord a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah. He's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be praised. Come on. He's the God that woke you up this morning. He's the God that started you on the way. He's the living God. He sits in the right throne of the Father of heaven. Hallelujah. He faints not, nor does he grow weary. Hallelujah. He knows your needs. Hallelujah. He knows the hairs that are on the top of your head. He knows what you're going through. He knows what you're struggling with. Just give it to him today.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Right now, Lord Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord Jesus.
Thank you,
Lord Jesus.
Hey, if that would only praise
you,
hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If that would only praise
you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. He's so worthy of all he's done for us.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
And we've done so little for him.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
It won't even match up on the scale.
Hallelujah.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Amen. I'm going to turn it over.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah in Jesus' name.
Thank you, Lord.
God bless you.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Good morning. Good morning. That's all. I'm the Lord's fan.
Hello.
Thank you. I'm coming from Psalm 15, verse 1 through 5. On the Lord's side.
Hallelujah.
Yes, Lord.
Amen.
A guideline for living a blameless life. Lord. Who may abide in your tabernacle?
Hallelujah.
Who may dwell in your holy hill? He who walks upright.
Oh, help us, God.
And works righteousness, and speaks the truth in his heart. He who does not backbite with his tongue, nor does evil to his neighbor, nor does he take up a reproach against his friend. And who has a veiled person that despised? But he honors those who fear the Lord. He who swears to his own hurt and does not change, he who does not put out his money in jewelry, nor does he take a bribe against the innocent. He who does these things shall never be moved.
Mm.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
The word of the Lord has been read this morning. Thank you.
Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Jesus. Let's give the Lord a hand praise. Amen. Amen. I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord. How many of you are soldiers in the army of the Lord? How many of you want to fight for the God? How many of you want to stand for righteousness?
Come on, come on.
How many of you want to stand for what's right?
Come on, come on.
With humility. Amen, Jesus. I'm a soldier in the army of the Lord.
Come on,
I feel good today, y'all.
Amen.
But I feel good today.
Come on, come on.
I feel wonderful today.
Yes.
Amen. 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 All right, now.
Thank you.
anyway. And Tuesday is Bishop's birthday.
All right.
And they want to do a special thing.
Amen.
For their granddaddy.
Amen.
Y'all pray for all mistakes. Take it for love. Because they did this just last night within 1 hour.
All right. Amen. That's dedication.
Amen.
All right.
People of God say amen.
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 Truly God is good.
Yeah.
Amen. Truly we can say like Israel, if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, where would I be? Where would I be today if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side? If God hadn't looked beyond my faults,
yes,
hallelujah, and saw all of my needs, even when I couldn't see them myself,
hallelujah,
but God,
but God,
and I thank Him today.
Amen.
We serve an awesome God.
Amen.
Amen. We give honor to the Spirit of the Lord who dwells in this place. Amen. To all of the deacons and ministers, to everybody in their respective place. Amen. To my wife. Amen. Our prophetess of the house.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. And El, I need you to step aside. Step to your left. There you go. Right there. There you go. I need my brother back there to be able to see.
Amen.
No, no, no. You're fine. You're fine. You're fine. You are right where you are. We thank God for them being in the house today.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Yeah. It's amazing. I was just sitting there watching these babies perform. And I got to thinking, I'm like, do they really know how blessed they are?
So true.
See, I'm Papa, but that's Granddaddy right there.
All right.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
That's Granddaddy.
All right now.
I'm just Papa.
Come on.
But do they really realize how blessed they are?
Yes. My.
To have people in their life that love them.
Hallelujah.
Care about them.
Thank you, Lord.
Want to see the best for them.
Come on. Yeah.
When some don't even have one.
Oh, my.
But y'all been blessed with two.
Amen.
Y'all hear me?
Yeah.
Don't take it for granted.
Amen.
Don't take it for granted. Y'all have been blessed with two.
Amen.
And the same rules that apply at that house, they apply at our house.
Amen.
See, we need to get more like that on one accord, parents and grandparents and pawpaws and whatever you are in someone's life.
Amen.
You need to get on the same page.
Amen. Amen.
Because we're losing too many. And obedience, you got to have obedience. You got to have rules.
Yes, sir.
That's right.
And rules are made to be followed, not broken.
That's right.
Come on now.
That's right.
They're made to be followed. And the word of God teaches us that if you can't rule the house of God, how are you going to rule your own house? God's house got rules.
That's
right. So our natural house has to what?
Have rules.
Amen. So they can't run from Papa to Granddad and run from Granddaddy back to Papa because we got you in the mill.
Come on.
You're caught up in the mill.
Come on.
Granddaddy said this, we're going to run back over and see what Papa said, the same thing. No difference. No difference at all. But we thank the Lord today. God is so good. We just give him praise, glory, and honor. And you hear me often say, even though this might be your first time, you're not a guest.
Amen.
Everybody is somebody in the house of God.
Amen.
Everybody is somebody.
Yes, Lord.
I don't believe in guests. I know it's just a custom, tradition to say guests and visitors. But when you enter into the door, you enter into the house of God.
That's right.
That's it.
You enter into where you can get some peace.
Yes, God. Mm-hmm.
Some joy.
Right.
Some happiness.
Yes.
Some deliverance.
All
get
right.
Whatever you need. Get it even down to an understanding all of right. Whatever you need.
That's right.
Amen.
If you want it. Amen.
I looked at something different, but then God, the Spirit of God, he just. Sometimes you think you're going one way, God says, we're going to go another way.
That's right.
He's the driver.
That's right.
Amen.
I'm just the passenger.
All right.
He drives the bus. I'm just riding on the bus.
All right now.
And whichever direction he wants to go with the bus,
that's good.
Who am I to say, I don't want to go that right. Let's make a left down here. No, we're going in that direction.
Amen.
But how many know today that there's a difference between living and existing?
All right.
All right.
Amen.
That's a big difference. A lot of people think they are living, but in reality, you're only existing. We think we're living because we got clothes on our back. We open the refrigerator up, there's food. We can get in the car and drive.
Right.
And we think we are living. But I'm going to take you a few scriptures to show you where some people are just existing. Because without God, you're just existing.
Amen.
You're not really living. You're just a walking, breathing being.
All right now.
Without God. That's all you are. Turn with me to Proverbs. We're going to start right there. Proverbs chapter 8. We're going to look at verse 35. And then we're going to conclude it. And I want Elder Milton to get Romans 14. Verse 7 through 12. If the Spirit of God let us make it there for us.
Amen.
Amen.
the difference between living and existing.
Yeah.
If you want to, you can write this down. There's a difference. Yes, yes, just because I'm breathing don't mean I'm living.
All right.
Well, how can you say that, Bishop? Because in Genesis it says that when God made man, he breathed into him and man became a living soul. You are a living soul, but you're not truly living.
Amen, amen.
Because if you were, Adam would still be around. Think about it. He would still be here. So he went from existing into living. Then he existed again. Mm. First time when God created him.
Yeah.
So in Proverbs chapter 8 and verse 35, do you have it?
Amen.
Okay, we're gonna start there. I just wanna talk with just a few minutes to us about this, because it's very important that people understand that there is a difference. That's a difference. Proverbs chapter 8. Yeah. That's a big difference, verse 35. That's a big difference. Yeah. Just because, you ever heard of coexisting?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That means you ain't fully existing. You part of them.
Yeah.
Right.
You coexisting.
Yeah.
That's just like with parents, when there's a separation and there's kids involved, you and both parents have a turn with them. That's called co-parenting. Help me, Holy Ghost.
Right now.
That's called co-parenting. You're not fully there, but you partly there.
Yeah. Come on.
Co.
Amen. Yeah.
Coexisting. But in God, we the scripture tells us that in him, we move, we breathe, and we have our being because of him.
Because of him.
Because of him. We got him.
Oh, because I got a good job.
No.
I got it going on myself. I bought this.
Uh-oh.
I did this.
Nope.
Without God, if God don't dispatch an angel to wake you up that morning, you don't do anything.
That's right.
Because you're not even living until he said, wake up.
That's right.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
You're somebody sleeping in a coma. You're just that close to death. But you go to bed angry, mad. Because the day didn't go like you wanted to go.
Right.
And then you feel like everybody owes you.
That's it.
And you lay down like that. And when you lay down like that, you don't realize that there's two angels there watching over your bed. We got the death angel and God got his angel.
All right.
And they got a conversation going on while you tossing and turning.
All right.
That's a conversation going on while you angry. Because the day didn't go like you wanted it to go. It wasn't your day anyway. It was God's day.
All right.
He gave you the day, and he gave you ability to make the day. So learn how to make the day and stop letting the day make you.
All right now.
Oh, hello, somebody. Let me get this thing going.
Go ahead.
When you learn how to make the day that God has given you, you are in control of the day.
Yes, sir.
The day is not in control of you, but so many people miss it because they feel like, it's got to be this way. It's got to go this way. If it don't go that way, something is wrong. Exactly. I get mad.
Right. That's true.
First of all, it wasn't your day.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
See, you want to go from existing. If you want to go from existing to living, then you got to learn how to do it like God said do. In the Lord's Prayer, he says, give us this day. Doesn't he?
Yeah.
Our daily bread.
Yep.
So that you don't make the day.
No, he gives it to you.
God gives it to you. Mm-hmm. He's already given you the ability and the authority over the day.
Yes, yes.
Oh, help me, help me here.
Yes, yes.
Go ahead, preach.
Yes, sir.
When you can understand that you're in charge of the day.
That's good.
And Satan knows that you're in charge of the day. That's why he throws a kink in the day. You got to know who's making the day distractive. It's the enemy. Because he knows you don't realize that you're truly in charge of the day.
Right,
but he knows that you're in charge of the day.
Right.
Because you are a spirit-speaking being.
Amen.
When you learn how to speak over your situation, when you learn how to speak over your life, over your thoughts, come on now.
Oh, yeah.
Then you begin to be in what? Charge of the day.
Right.
And you wonder why your day going like it is?
Right.
You ain't speaking over your day. You letting the day control you.
All right.
Law and the job, they don't understand. They cutting up. But if you confessing to be saved, or if you trying to get in that area of being saved, guess what? They supposed to cut up on the job.
All right.
They supposed to act up on you.
Yeah.
They ain't supposed to love you. What fellowship does day and night have?
None.
What relationship does Jesus and the devil have?
None.
He was in heaven, but guess what? He wanted to take over. So guess what? He got the boot.
That's right.
Amen.
So we got to learn the difference between living and existing. Proverbs 8:35. Let me get there. Read from Elder.
For whoso findeth me, findeth life,
mm-hmm.
and shall obtain favor of the Lord.
So whoso findeth me, you may take a seat. God said, now, if you find me, you're going to find life.
All right.
Right.
Yeah.
That's good.
And not only are you going to find life, but you're going to get some favor behind it.
My.
Why do you think God said in his word, he said, when a man finds a wife, he finds a good thing.
All right.
And then he obtains the favor of the Lord over his life. And you wonder, hello, you too. Don't let me leave you out, please.
Come on.
And you wonder why some brothers still running around. They ain't found a wife.
Come on.
They running with women, but they ain't found their wife. Because when you find a wife, you find a good thing.
Uh-oh.
And then you obtain favor from the Lord. So wait. If you're single, wait on
him. Yes, Lord.
Wait on him. If you're a single man, wait on your wife.
Amen.
Stop just jumping at a woman. But learn how to wait on your wife.
That's it.
And young women, wait on your husband.
That's it. Amen.
Because when you find them, he said, now, so the same thing goes together when you find life, when you find Jesus.
Okay.
See, he ain't lost. We the one be lost.
All right now.
But when you find him, you find it life. So in other words, you're trying to tell me, preacher, that I don't have life. Not if you don't have Jesus, you sure don't.
That's right.
I say it again. If you don't have Jesus, you don't have life.
Right. Amen, amen.
Right.
That's what the word just said.
That's
now.
True.
I'm just a messenger.
Yes,
but that's what the word tells us. If when we find him, we find life, and then we find what? Favor. You wonder why blessings come your way sometimes and you ain't even looking?
Amen.
Man, hallelujah.
That's because you done found
Jesus. Hallelujah.
And in him,
Life. Thank you, Lord.
And when you find him, you find life.
My.
And you find favor.
My God, thank you, Lord.
He tells us in the Old Testament that the blessings would overtake you. If you get in the arena.
Yes, God.
If you get in the right place.
Thank you, Lord.
Well, I know I'm blessed. You ain't living a dime. Well, he did say he reigned on the just as well as the unjust.
That's right. That is
some
true.
Folks just get blessed by who they hanging around with.
That's true.
Some folks are blessed by association.
Uh-huh.
You ain't living nothing. You ain't doing nothing. But just because of the people that you're around, you get a blessing.
Amen.
And you ain't living nothing. But you're getting blessed.
Yeah. Amen.
Just because who you're around.
Amen.
So when you find God,
right.
And the scripture, and shall obtain
favor.
Obtain the favor of the Lord. So when I come to my senses and realize that all of what I'm doing ain't by the hill of beans,
because
I don't have Jesus.
All right. In vain.
So everything I just did it.
Mm.
Yeah.
The cliche says living on borrowed time.
All right now.
But your time gonna run out.
Mm.
Huh?
Amen.
Your time gonna run out.
Yeah.
So it behooves us now to get it right.
That's right.
And if you don't feel like you really got life, and you know that you exist because you know you better than I do.
All right.
You know well or not if you got life. You know whether or not if you're just going through everyday motion.
Come on.
You know this. For your own self. So you know if you don't have life, but we're looking at where, let's get life.
Amen.
And the more we get life, the more we begin to enjoy life.
Yes.
Yes.
The more we begin to love.
Mm-hmm.
Know how to love. Because without Jesus, you really don't know how to love.
That's right.
You're going through the stages of what's called love station.
All right. All right.
You mean really learn how to love. Because the scripture says that love has a multitude of sin.
All right.
That's the word.
A multitude.
Mm.
You ain't always looking at what I did. You're looking at where I'm at now.
Mm-hmm.
You're looking at where I picked up at. You're looking where the change came in. You're looking for the transformation.
Amen, amen.
The new person.
Yeah.
Because if our salvation was based on the things we did, then right. we wouldn't be saved.
That's right.
All right.
It wouldn't be enough.
We wouldn't be. We really wouldn't be. But because of love, Jesus stayed on the cross, and because of love, he went all the way.
All the way.
All the way.
Because of love. Love is what kept him there.
Yeah.
It wasn't deeds.
Thank you, Lord.
My God.
It wasn't nothing we did. We wasn't even in that generation, but that generation was so wicked, they rejected him.
Yep.
But he still went to the cross.
Yes. Yes.
And he stayed right there because it was love that kept him in.
Thank you, Lord.
Even with every nail that was driven in his hand, it was love.
Amen.
When they put him in his feet,
thank you, God.
It was love.
Amen.
When they stretched him out,
thank you,
it was love.
Thank you.
When they stuck that rugged cross in a hole and held him up there, it was love.
Thank you, Lord.
Because remember, he said, now, I have legions of angels.
Uh-huh.
All I got to do is just look towards heaven.
Right.
I ain't even got to open my mouth. But I just look that way. They'll come take me off this cross.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But for your sake and my sake,
thank you.
He stayed right there.
Yeah.
And all he asked us to do is just serve him.
Amen.
That's all he asked us to do.
Yes, Lord.
We give jobs time, we give folks time, but then come down to the house of God, we don't want to give no time.
Come on now.
We find every excuse
right.
not to come out.
You better say it, bitch.
Every
Lord.
Excuse.
Speak, Lord.
I got to work. That's understandable if you have to work on a Sunday. I do understand that. Some jobs require you to work on Sunday.
Yeah.
I do understand that. But every now and then, you need to walk through the door.
All right.
Amen.
Of some house.
Yes.
Every now and then,
amen.
You need to show your face in some house.
Yes.
Yes.
Come on. Don't just ride by, well, I would, you know, but.
Yeah.
But. Don't let but cause you to end up in hell.
All right.
Because that's what but would do for you. But is an excuse not to.
Mm-hmm.
So even in the process of going through, and even in 1 Peter, he tells us to, for as much as Christ has suffered in the flesh, to arm ourselves likewise. Put on the same mind that you're going to go through something.
That's right.
Put on the same mind that life is not a cakewalk.
That's right.
Every day, he didn't promise you that every day was going to be a floating day that you just breeze right through it. You're going to have some ups and some downs. Because Jesus himself said, in this world, we shall have trials and what? Tribulations.
Amen.
Be a good cheer.
Trials and tribulations. Now, let me explain something. We're going through trials. We have not hit tribulations yet. A lot of people came up to my, you know, trials and tribulations. Hold up, sweetie. Hold up. Stop.
Yeah.
You in trials.
Yes.
You have not hit tribulation.
My God, glory.
We go through little trials down here.
Mm-hmm.
But we have not hit tribulations.
Oh.
Tribulations is worse than a trial. Tribulation is going to tell you who you really are.
That's right. Who you stand for.
Tribulation is going to say, do you really love Jesus?
Right.
Are you willing to die for Jesus?
Right.
How far are you willing to go for this Jesus?
Right.
That's what tribulation is going to say.
Right.
Trials we go through. Well, I got this bill. The money's short. That's okay. God still will make a way.
Amen.
That's true.
And God will send somebody along to bless you.
Yes, he will.
God will make a way for you because he said, I am the way, the truth, and the life.
Yes, he will.
Yes, yes.
He'll make a way, but we ain't hit tribulation.
My God, no.
Tribulation. Whole different arena.
Yes.
Yeah. Tribulation said you can't buy nothing.
Mm.
Even though you got the money.
Right.
You got the resources.
That's right.
But tribulation said you can't buy it.
That's right.
Tribulation said it ain't time for you to get this. You got to get in line
all
to
right.
get this.
True.
God,
tribulation. So stop telling people you got trials and tribulations. Tell people, yeah, I'm going through some stuff, but God got me.
That's right.
Leave it right there. I'm going through some things. I'm going through some changes and some situations, but God got me.
Yes.
Don't be hollering tribulation. Don't speak something on you that hadn't happened yet.
That's true.
Because you can't do that. You go from a situation to you tore up from the flow up. Can't buy a break. Let's not get one. Now you realize I'm in tribulation. But that's a difference. That's a big difference. Trials. So we have to understand that, ask yourself, am I existing or am I living? Self-explanatory. Am I living? If I'm living, I'm living according to God's word.
Right.
If I'm living, I'm living because he lives.
Yeah.
I'm living, if I'm living, I can face tomorrow.
That's right.
Because he lives.
Yeah.
And not only that, he lives in me.
That's right.
That's my main reason for knowing that I'm living.
All right.
I'm not existing because in Christ. I can do all things who what? Strengthens me. But if you just existing, you can't say that.
That's right. That's right.
Because he's got to be in you.
Amen, amen.
Not around you.
True.
You can show up for service and service can be hot. I mean, hot, hot, hot. Holy Ghost can be moving.
Yeah, all
but except it get in you.
All around you.
You leave with a good, awesome feeling.
That's it.
Just temporary.
Yep.
Because it didn't get in you. It was just around you.
Right.
And there's a difference when it gets in you.
Yes.
When you come into the house and you get saved and you get filled, there's a difference. You not only leave out living, you leave out living and running.
All right now.
You go from me. I was existing when I walked in the house, but now I'm living.
Yeah.
Then I can become a living testimony. I can say God did this. If it had not been for the Lord who was on my side, where would I be? Then I can testify like Israel here said. Israel said, if it had not been for the Lord who was on my side. They looked around and the Israelites looked back and said, if it had not been for God that brought us through the Red Sea. If it had not been for God that fed us when we was in the wilderness. But now I can see. If it had not been for the Lord who was on my side. Israel had to realize they had to go from existing to living. The whole time they was in Egypt, they was just existing. So some of you got to get out of Egypt.
That's right.
So you can start living.
Yes. God,
I need to say that again. Come out of Egypt. Egypt in my mind. Get out of Egypt. So you can get over on the Lord's side. So you can begin to what? Live. The fruitful life that he already laid out for you. It's amazing that if you really understand the difference, and I can't get off this today because this, I'm about to turn this into a series.
Amen.
God dealt with me this morning about it. It's amazing when you really understand that all these years, I've just been existing. Not really living. I began to live my best life. I existed on this earth for 34 years. And at the age of 34, God saved me.
Yes.
Filled me with his Holy Ghost.
Amen.
Then I began to experience what life
Amen.
Really was.
Yeah.
When I thought I had it all together.
All right.
I didn't know, I didn't even realize that this kind of love and this kind of life even existed.
Mm.
But God.
Yeah.
But God. So when you get over on the Lord's side, you know what life is all about.
All right.
Huh? God even gives you, he gives the life he gives you, he gives you life and confidence to overcome any situation,
Amen.
Any circumstance that comes up in your life. Huh?
All right, now
you get sick, I just said by his stripes, we already healed.
That's right.
All you got to do is speak your healing, speak your deliverance. Because why? I went from existence to being living. Huh? When God formed Adam from the dust, and Adam just laid there, Adam existed.
All right.
But he wasn't living.
Right.
Hmm.
Until God
breathed the life.
The breath of life, into his nostrils.
Yeah.
And Adam got up.
Yeah. Amen. Hallelujah.
He got up then.
Yeah.
Because why? He began to what? Live.
Yeah.
And when he got up, God gave him the rules and the regulations of what he wanted him to do.
Right.
How he wanted him to do it.
Yeah.
Take care of everything. That's all you got to do, Adam.
Yeah.
Gave you the knowledge to name animals.
Yeah.
You done woke up from the dust. You don't even know nothing about an animal. But he's already instilled in you what an animal is.
Uh-huh.
And what to name the animal.
Yeah.
He only existed. So are we existing or are we just living?
Yes.
I want to live.
Amen. Me too.
Living for Christ is the best life you'll live.
Oh, but it's true anyway.
That's the best life you'll live.
Yeah.
Best life. I've been out there. Sure. I've been out there. Been there, done that. Got a hat, t-shirt, mug, trophy.
All right now.
Because I was good at it.
All right now.
I was good at it.
Yeah.
I was good at it when I was out there. And say no, I was good at it.
Yeah.
But God.
But God.
See, God got a time set for everybody.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Now, you can ignore it.
Yes, you can.
And just prolong things for yourself. Mm-hmm. Make it worse for yourself. But every now and then, God will tug on that inner man in you. Because
yeah.
Why? He put it in you.
Yeah.
He put the inner man in you. So every now and then, he's going to tug on that inner man.
Amen.
He's going to let you know, hey, you know, you need to stop by the house today. I got something for you. I need you to hear this. But we'll ignore it. No, I got something else to do. You know, I just got home. And,
No,
I ain't hearing it today. I don't want to go by there today.
Yeah.
And God said, okay. That's all right. He ain't going to wipe you out.
All right now.
He just dropped something else in front of you.
That's right.
Yes, sir.
He'll drop another situation in front of you.
Yeah.
And then you want to go hide, Lord have mercy. Well, I had the mercy, but you didn't come to the seat.
All right now.
And then you wonder why situations rise up in your life.
Why not?
Things happen. Disobedience. Just don't want to hear that. Just don't want to do that.
Yes.
Right? That's all right. See, we serve an awesome God that he's not going to interrupt your plan right then.
All right.
He'll let you go right on
with
your plan and do exactly what you think you big enough and bad enough to do.
That's right.
But then the time comes, he snatches you.
My God.
He snatches you right back.
Right.
So not today. And he'll snatch on you and keep snatching on till you finally look up and say, okay, God.
There he is.
He knows how to wear you out.
Yeah.
Trust me. He knows how to wear you out. Give me just a little bit of Romans 14 and we're going to get out of here.
Thank you, Lord God.
Lord, yes.
For to this end, what scripture, Bishop?
7:14, chapter 14, verse 7.
For none of us liveth to himself.
No, hold up. I wake myself up in the morning. I get up and put my own clothes on. I put gas in my own car. So I'm doing all this on my own. Everything I got, I did it.
Yeah.
Ain't nobody gave me nothing.
Mm-mm.
Read.
For none of us liveth to himself.
And no, hold up, I do. Huh? When you in the world, who you living to?
The enemy.
Which is your what? Yourself.
Mm-hmm.
You become your own what? Worst enemy.
That's right.
Because you're living to yourself. You're not living to God.
Mm-mm.
Because you're not knowing the things of God.
That's
so
right.
That means you're living to yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Read.
And no man dieth to himself.
No man dieth to himself. Read.
For whether we live
Whether we live.
We live unto the Lord.
We live unto the Lord.
And whether we die.
Whether we die.
We die unto the Lord.
We die unto the Lord.
Whether we live, therefore.
Uh-huh.
Or die.
Or die.
We are the Lord's.
We are the Lord. So either way you look at it, you belong to God.
Amen.
All
right. All right.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
You belong to him. Amen. You don't belong to yourself.
All right.
You belong to God.
Amen.
When you die by yourself.
Right.
When you are born by yourself.
Show love.
Unless you had a twin coming behind you. But when we leave here, we leave what? By ourselves. That's why we got to make sure that when we leave here, we are wrapped up, tangled up, tied up in Christ.
Amen.
Dying ain't bad. The bad part about it is when you die, you don't have Christ.
All right, that's it.
Because the scripture said on that day when Gabriel blows the trumpet, the dead that are in Christ, that are in Christ, shall rise first. And they that are left, that remain, whether you have died or whether you're walking around or whether you're jugging in a club,
all right,
wherever you are,
yeah,
God said, you coming up that day. That time, you coming up. Guess what? And it's amazing we all going to go up to be judged in the clouds with 10,000 of his saints. That's a lot of judges. But check this out. Everybody can't stay. Everybody can't stay. We all going up. But everybody can't stay. Because when they open the book and they... which is called the Book of Life.
All right, that's it.
And they begin to look for your name.
In the Lamb's Book of Life. Hallelujah.
And every deed that was ever done in the body, mm-hmm, good or bad,
yeah,
God got an angel sitting there looking.
Yeah.
I told the church yesterday, it's bad to live 20, 25, 30, 40 years, or maybe 50 or longer, and God opened up the book. And so you only showed up 10 times.
My.
Can't say, Lord.
Have mercy.
You don't have nothing to say. You have no excuse. None. But let us begin to live a life that's pleasing to God.
Amen.
Come over on the Lord's side. The praise team sung it. Come over on the Lord's side.
Yeah.
So you can receive the goodness.
Hallelujah, the benefits. Come on.
That God has in store for you.
Yeah,
yeah, Lord.
You struggle because you want to struggle.
Mm.
That's why you struggle.
Yeah.
You want to struggle. God said we should be the head.
Not the tail.
Not the tail.
Amen.
Above and not beneath.
Yeah.
So we struggle and we go through because we choose to do that. You choose to do that. When God saved me and I began to reap his benefits, I didn't even look back. I had nothing to look back at.
That's right.
That's why today all the enemy has is your past. He can't tell you where you're going.
He can't.
He know your past. So when he comes after you with an attack, that's all he comes after with, what you and I once knew. That's all he got, what we used to do, how we used to be. But the old man is not there. The old man ain't there no more. I'm a new creature.
Yeah.
Tell yourself you're a new creature.
Yeah.
And if you found yourself in this message today, part one, if you found yourself where you just existing, well, I open up the door for you to start living.
Yes, Lord. Yes, Lord.
To live for Christ. To live, not to just exist, but to become a living soul. Because God loves us what? Just that much.
Amen.
And all he asks us to do is just serve him.
Yes.
Praise him.
Amen.
Worship him.
Amen.
What's hard about that? I asked the question, I'm still asking the question. Why do you even come to church? Do you really know why you come to church?
My God.
That's a good question you need to know. And that's the answer you need to know. Why did we come to church?
That's right.
But let us look at it. If we're not existing, then we're living.
Oh, Jesus.
If we're not, we got to learn how to do it. To exist. See, God gave you the existence when he allowed you to come into the world.
Mm. Yes.
But he said, now you need to start living.
Yes.
Amen.
Start living for him. Because the world is on its way out of here.
Amen.
Rapidly.
My God.
Unfolding fast.
Yes, it is.
Real fast. So if I was you today, I'd make up my mind. I would choose to live for God.
Amen.
Live for God.
Yes.
Live for God.
Amen.
Live for God. Go right on through whatever situation you're going through. Just keep right on going and knowing that God got you.
All right. Amen.
Because situation's going to come up on the saints. That's what he said.
Amen.
Yes. But Paul said, I can do all things.
Through Christ Jesus.
Through Christ Jesus.
Strengthens me.
Who strengthens me.
Amen.
And he strengthens me because he's in me.
That's right.
Amen. We thank God today. Hope you enjoyed the word. Amen. We had to, couldn't get it all in. It's going to be a conclusion. Of the difference between existing and living.